Matthew, the book of Matthew, chapter 27, and then we're going to go to the book of Ephesians. I had, God gave me a word yesterday, and he gave me another word this morning. And the Lord spoke to me to bring this to you this morning, and I thank God what he gave to me this morning to bring to you this midday. Amen. The book of Matthew, chapter 27. Easy book to find. If you can't find Matthew, you know what you need to do. Come on, lay them hands on you. You've been saved over 5 years, you can't find Matthew? Been in church all your life? Can't find the book of Matthew? Something wrong, brother. Matthew 27, chapter. Hallelujah. 27. Let's look at verse 45 down to 51. Amen. Matthew 27, 45 down to 51. The Bible said, now from the sixth hour there was darkness over the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? That's powerful. He felt the separation from the presence of God because of us on him. Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, this man calleth for Elijah. And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink. The Bible said there, said the rest said, let us see whether Elijah will come to save them. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. That means he died, his spirit departed from his body. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain, or was split in two from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake and the rocks did rent. I want you to remember, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to the bottom. The book of Ephesians, book of Ephesians, hallelujah. Book of Ephesians. Amen. Chapter 2. Hallelujah. Everybody got Ephesians chapter 2? Amen. The Bible. Ephesians chapter 2. Let's look at it, verses 11 down to 18. Got it? Bible said, wherefore remember that you, say me, that you being in times past Gentiles in the flesh. Gentiles are those that are outside of the Jewish race. So if you're not a Jew, you are a Gentile. No matter what your race is, you are considered Gentiles in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision. The Jews were circumcised. Everybody outside of them wasn't. Amen. And so we was called the uncircumcision. Amen. We was uncircumcised. Amen. In the flesh made by hands. That at that time you were without Christ. See, we was without Christ. Listen, only men or males was able to be circumcised. But the one verse said all of us in Christ are circumcised. How is women circumcised? We're circumcised in Christ. When God bruised his flesh, he cut you off too. Your flesh was cut off too. Sin was cut off your life. Come on, son. The foreskin of sin was cut. Hallelujah. My God, he said, that at that time you were without Christ. There was a time all of us was without Christ. We was outside of salvation. How many was outside of salvation? Now, if you didn't raise your hand, that means you was born with the Holy Ghost. You came out the womb speaking in tongues. Come on now. You came out the womb. No, you didn't. You was born in sin. You was shaping in iniquity. You was born with Adam's, the nature of Adam upon you. Come on now. But at that time, you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel. We was alienated from the blessings that Israel had. Amen. We didn't enjoy the benefits. Anybody outside the Jewish race did not enjoy the benefits that the Jews enjoyed as being God's people. And strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope. There was a time we didn't have no hope. You didn't expect nothing from God. All you was looking for was your next dream. And without God in the world. But now. Look at somebody, tell them, but now. Tell them things have changed now. But now, in Christ, you who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Jesus Christ. My God, we was one time at a distance from God. We was without hope. We was without God in this world. But when you got saved, the blood drew you close to God. Hallelujah. It sanctified you. It erased your past. Hallelujah. It brought you into the promises of God. The blood did that. For he is our peace. Oh, that peace again. He is. I got peace. I got Jesus. Come on, how many got peace? I got Jesus. You might be disturbed in your mind. You might be going through trials. Anybody might be trying to depress you. But you got to realize you got something bigger than what you don't have. I got Jesus. I got peace. My God. What's peace? I got peace. My relationship with God is at peace. Jesus bridged the gap between me and God. He gave me peace with God. Lord, I ain't talking about kind of peace where I'm not disturbed because things you go through can't disturb you. I'm talking about my relationship with. I have made peace with God through Jesus Christ, my Lord. Lord, I don't have a broken down relationship with him. I've been reconciled. I've been brought back to God through the death of Jesus Christ. Do y'all believe that? If y'all believe it, give God some praise. For he is our peace.
Oh, yes, he is.
Who had made, I like this, both one. And had broken down the middle wall of partition between. Remember, the veil was rent. He broke it down, the middle wall. A partition between us, between Jews and Gentiles. I broke the barrier down. There's no more division. Having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances. For to make in himself of twain, or two rather, one new man. So marking peace, and that he might reconcile both unto God in one body. Black man, white man, Hispanic man, Chinese man, all nations. He said through his death he reconciled us all, the two outside of Jewish nation, whatever your nation is. He said outside of the Jewish nation, I brought you in. He said, I've reconciled the two to be in one body. In other words, you can't look at me and think you're better because you're a Jew. The same blood that saved me is the same blood got to save you. He said, and that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby. In other words, he took down the racial barrier. And came and preached peace to you which were afar off and to them which were nigh. For through him we both have access to one spirit unto the Father. He said, now therefore you are no more strangers. And how many thank God you're not a stranger to the promises? You're not a foreigner. I got access to forgiveness and grace. But fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God. I'm going to read a few of these out of the Message Bible. Y'all bear with me. I'm going to read verse 14 and 15 out of the Message Bible. He said, the Messiah has made things up between us so that we're now together on this, both non-Jews, Jewish outsiders, and Jewish distant. The Messiah has made things up between us so that we're now together on this, both non-Jewish outsiders and Jewish insiders. He tore down the wall we used to keep each other at a distance. He repealed the law code that had become so clogged with fine print and footnotes that it hindered more than it helped. The law hindered more than it helped. Then he started over. Instead of continuing with two groups of people separated by centuries of animosity and suspicion, he created a new kind of human being. A fresh start for everybody. My thought this morning to you is entitled, Jesus Tore Down Racial Barriers. Jesus tore down racial barriers. How many believe that he did? How many believe he did? He tore down racial barriers. I was down this morning praying, and I was meditating on the voice of God. Amen. He began to speak to me. I was leaving out the house this morning to come up here to the church. I just turned the TV on. I just heard somebody read this verse about how God made the two one. And I just heard it and I left it alone. And God said, I need you to deal with that today. Let's deal with racial barriers. Racism. Y'all bear with me this morning. Racism is the belief that groups of humans possess different behavior traits corresponding to physical appearance and can be divided based on the superiority of one's race over the other. Racism is prejudice, discrimination, antagonism directed against someone of a different race based on the superiority of one's race over another. Brothers and sisters, you ever heard of white supremacy? White supremacy is the racist belief that Caucasian people are superior to those of other races and thus should dominate them. Brothers and sisters, there has been so many deaths on black people at the hands of Caucasian people because they feel their white skin made them superior over the so-called inferior black African American. White supremacy just didn't begin a few years ago. Y'all bear with me now. It just didn't begin 15 years ago. It just didn't begin 20 years ago. You got to rewind back to 400 years. White supremacy was inflicted on slaves in America. And we are still seeing it now. Oh, y'all quiet on me here. They inflicted what they call so-called white supremacy because they felt that their skin made them more powerful than anybody else on the earth. Y'all quiet, Lord. And God died, Jesus died, to break down the barriers of racists and racism. Oh, y'all quiet here now. You know, when slavery, we couldn't read or write. We was only told or believe what we was told. The slave master would take this Bible and he would flip it and make you feel like black skin was evil and white skin was right. Let me tell you what slaved black folks. Wasn't so much plantations. Wasn't so much cotton picking. But what enslaved us the most was what they told us in our minds. We believed we supposed to be slaves. We believed that we was inferior. We believed that, amen, the white man was God and Jesus was white. Oh, come on now. Now I'm not gonna steal. I don't believe in a lot of stuff like this. But I gotta prove. I gotta break something down to you.
Come on, preacher.
Oh, y'all hear me here? And so, amen. We call him master because he was taught us that he was our master. Come on, somebody. The Bible said slaves shall obey their masters. They took that scripture and programmed us to believe that there was our master. We couldn't read the Bible for ourselves. Y'all quiet on me here. And so, white supremacy.
Y'all don't like this, do you?
They used their skin to make us believe that there was something greater than us upon the earth. You got black supremacy. You got black organizations. Believing that black skin is the most superior people upon the earth. That's not true. Y'all come on. They tell my black folks is the God of the earth. And all of it, let me tell you, no. That's still racism. Come on. To look at somebody else's skin to say that God didn't call you, he called us as black people. You know, they got groups now talking about he only died for black people and he only came for black folks, and anybody outside of black race, amen, ain't of God, and all this, the black man is the original Jew and all this. And I'm not a Jew, I'm a black man. Come on, somebody. I'm not a Jew. Y'all got quiet. I am not a Jew. You're not a Jew. You're not a Jew. You're not a Jew. We are black folks that was considered Gentiles, that was brought into the commonwealth. We was brought into salvation by the blood of Jesus. Can I get a witness here? Because you got white Jews and you got dark-skinned Jews too. Oh, y'all, come on, somebody. Amen. We listen, let me tell you something. Now, we're not Jews by race, but we are Jews inwardly. The Bible said we are Jews inwardly. Amen. When I got saved and I came over into salvation, I became the son of Christ. I became the blessed, amen, of Christ. Amen. I am Abraham's seed, and I'm blessed by God by being Abraham's seed. I'm not his seed through genetics, but I'm his seed through the blood of Jesus. Can I get a witness? I am inside. I'm a Jew by spirit. Oh, can I get a witness here now? And man, we still got this racial stuff going on. Folks using their skin color, believing that they're greater than somebody else because of the color of their skin. But the devil is a liar. Oh, y'all hear me now? We shouldn't have no phobias of nobody else because they've got a different race or a different color than you, because they got a better suit on than you and they carrying a briefcase. I can't get nobody. Lord have mercy. Oh, my God, listen. My skin tone don't make me who I am. My skin tone don't make me what I am. It's the blood of Jesus that make me who I am. Can I get somebody to lift your hands in here and give God some praise? Come on, give God some praise in here. And you know what's so sad? You still got some black people that still have a slave mentality. Oh, y'all got quiet. Y'all come on, somebody. The white man got his foot on my neck. They had your foot on your neck 400 years ago. His foot is off my neck. I can't get nobody. Y'all come on, somebody. The white man ain't the only one that can be rich. You can be rich. You can be blessed. You can be prosperous. I can't hear nobody. We can't just down ourselves. Y'all, can I get a witness up in here now? Oh, God brought us from a mighty long way. Can I get somebody to give God some praise up in here this morning? You treat all men equal. Come on, we treat everybody equal. Can I get a witness now? And I love the different races. I love everybody. I love seeing intermixed races. I love seeing that. It's beautiful to me. It's showing me the complexity of God. It's showing me that God is a God of manifold wisdom. Can I get a witness up in here? Because you look down your family tree, you might have some Caucasian in your family. Shake that tree. I know I got something else in me. And we want to sit here and try to judge another nation of people because your skin color is not the color of my skin. And the people you judge, it could have been your great, 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 great grandfather race. I can't get nobody here. And the people you looking at to be inferior, you could be looking at yourself because some of that race might be inside of you. We going somewhere. Y'all just brought with me here. Oh, y'all just brought with me here. Calling the white man the devil. You ain't seen the devil. You see no white man. The devil is a liar. Come on. You don't know the devil then. If you think the devil is a white man, you don't know Satan. Blue eyed. Listen. That's up the devil. You think a man is the devil? You sadly mistaken. Can I get a witness here now? Because I see some black devils too. I see some Hispanic devils. I see some Chinese devils. I see Russian devils. Now come on, somebody. We see the Saudi Arabian devils. We see devils out of any race. Because the Bible says he that sinned it is of the devil. He that sinned it, white man, black man, yellow man, he that sinned it is of the devil. But we see so much in unjust injustice in this world, or especially in America. And God did not put high emphasis on race like man has. Because when you love your race to the point where you'll kill somebody. Because you ain't of my color. What you doing in here? Y'all come on, somebody. And it's sad. Some races don't like to see you looking good. They don't think you should be wearing a suit. You shouldn't be educated. Come on, somebody. That's of the devil to me. Come on, somebody. But Jesus died to break down the racial barriers. That's why I don't operate in that kind of... Listen, you don't understand where I come from. I came out of stuff like this. God brought me out of racial barrier. He brought me out of being racist and being prejudiced. I can't get nobody. I had it bad. I used to be bad at it. Because of what I was taught. And if God would deliver me, I'd probably be a mini Malcolm X right now. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. Y'all come on. He delivered me from looking at skin and seeing the contents of the people's heart. It's one religion talking about the white race was created by a black man in a lab named Yacoub. You liar. Y'all come on, somebody. That is rooted in racism. And the Bible says he that hated his brother had not eternal life abiding in him. Because my brothers, my white brothers, my Hispanic brothers, my Chinese brothers, they are my brothers. Especially in Christ, you are my brother. Can I get a witness up in here? We got to get back this stuff. You know, some of our churches, our black churches are predominantly black. We understand what I'm saying. And if a person of a different race walk in, they look at them crazy, look at them inside their head because, listen, you ain't been used to a man integrating. You so used to the black style and the black people. But I love seeing
different races walk in the church. I like seeing different styles of singing. I like seeing different styles of worship. It might be a little funny to us because we didn't use how they shout, but we still like it. Come on. It might look funny how they shout, but they don't shout like us. But they shouting with us. You don't sing like us, but you singing with us. You know, they praise like this. But they praise him. You might laugh, but they praising. Yeah, y'all supposed to be turning that tambourine up. But they might be having one beat. But they love God. Can I get somebody here? I had a bad prejudice spirit. Crazy. Y'all don't think I'm playing. I had a bad racial spirit. I'm just saying, I might not come with you from where you come from. But I came from a church that taught that white people was the devil. I was terrible. But God had to get this mind. Who can I get a witness? And take all that junk out of it. My first job was downtown Dallas, working in that big old bar. And I couldn't stand white folks. Well, I couldn't stand them. That was the devil, man. They come in that elevator with me. Boy, put me right in the midst of them. They nice suits. And even though they prejudiced, they racist, but you got to love them. Y'all quiet. Come on. Love your enemies. My enemies, those that hate my skin color. You got to love them anyway. What it look like I'm hating you, you hate me. We get nowhere like that. Come on, somebody got to show God's love for real. How can you say you love God who you're not seeing, but hate your brother who you see every day? You boys, quiet. Come on. You can't tell me you love God and you hate your brother. Why you my brother? We came from the same earth. Listen, you my brother because we came from the same mother. We came from Mother Earth. And we're going right back to mother again.
Y'all better hear me now.
Because when you die and I die. No, take that back. When I die compared to a Caucasian fellow. And I've been dead 10 years. They've been dead 10 years. Dig us up. What color are you going to see? Dirt. So anything that go back to the dirt ain't got no power. Color go back to the dust. Y'all come on.
We go back to the dust. You ain't got no blue eyes, Caucasian man. I ain't gonna have no dark brown eyes, black man.
My hair gonna be gone. Yours too. That white pale skin gonna be gone. My black skin gonna be gone too. And they putting so much emphasis on skin color.
See, in 2013, three radical black women organizers created a black centered political will and movement building project called Black Lives Matter. Oh, y'all hear me? Black Lives Matter is a political and social movement. Let me flip my page. It is a political and social movement originating among African Americans, emphasizing basic human rights and racial equality for black Americans and campaigning against various forms of racism. So letting us know Black Lives Matter. In the midst of all this injustice, black lives do matter.
because they have treated us like we don't matter. But if you get hooked up in all that, you're going to be out there marching and burning up buildings and busting out windows to prove that our lives matter. You got to believe that to believe that you matter. Well, the Black Lives Movement began in 2013. But Black Lives Matters was expressed to us on the cross over 2,000 years ago. He already showed me that I matter. Y'all quiet on me. Why we wait till 2013 and realize Black Lives Matter? I understand all the injustice and how they treat us. But the question is, how do you respond to it? I can't get nobody, y'all. Over 2,000 years ago, he died to show me that Black Lives Matter. Jesus showed us that all lives mattered when he hung, bled, and died on the cross over 2,000 years ago. Can I get a witness? He died to show me that all races matter to me. Because when you look at it, Minister Casey, he bought us back. He bought the black man and the white man and the red man and the yellow man. He bought us away from sin. We were sold into sin, but he purchased us. He redeemed us and brought us back to God. Can I get somebody here that believes that our races matter? Or can I get a witness here? All races matter to God. It don't matter what who you are and where you've been. It don't matter what you've done. You might have been a Ku Klux Klan member, but he can save the Ku Klux Klan. He can save the Black Panthers. I can't get nobody. He can save racism. He can save you. Come on. He didn't die for us to march in the street. He died for us to be free. That's when the Son set free. He is free. Boy, I can't get nobody here now. I said he's free indeed. Go on, lift your hands and give God some praise. How many thank God you're free? Oh, glory, hallelujah. I was free before the Emancipation Proclamation. Can I get a witness? My forefathers was free before Abraham Lincoln signed it. Slaves will go free. Yes, you're free men naturally. But I was already free. And we just didn't know it. We was already free. We was already justified. We was already sanctified. Oh, can I get a witness in here now? And so when Jesus died on the cross, he just didn't die for black people. He just didn't die for white people. But he shed his blood for all nations so that we will have an opportunity to receive the remission of our sins. It didn't matter what color you were. No matter what color you are, you need a savior. Come on. You need somebody that's going to that have died for you and shed the blood for you to have a chance to come on in and be delivered. I come to tell you somebody this morning, he broke down the racial barriers. When God look at me, he's not looking at a black man. When God look at you, he's not looking at Hispanic. Can I get a witness and hear? My God, Lord have mercy. And so brothers and sisters, we should love our race and study our heritage and study our history, but we should love our race from out of the context of salvation. Oh, y'all hear what I'm saying? I can't make a religion about my race. Y'all quiet on me now, Lord. I can't sit and make a black religion. Y'all better hear me now, because it ain't about black people. It's all about Jesus. Look at your neighbor, tell him it's all about Jesus. When was it all about Jesus? The moment he died on that cross, it was about him for us. Watch this. It's about Jesus to us. And it was about us to him. But when he died for us, he had us on his mind. I was a wretch undone. I was seeking to live a rise again. But the master,
said. Can I get somebody? Oh, Lord, help us. Yes, black lives matter. Yes, I'm a human being. My life matters. You got cops killing black people. Oh, y'all hear me now? Killing young black people. Folks is jogging, and they killing them. Killing black folks in their home while they're asleep. Killing young black boys just driving down the street, taking our lives out of here. Oh, yes, our lives matter. But let's look at the other side. You got black folks killing white cops. Could I get a witness in retaliation to what they're doing to us? That's a barrier, said God. I died to take down the racial barrier. Kill that man. Had his knee on his neck. That boy had served up some stuff. Oh, his life mattered. George Floyd's life mattered. And that white man that they shot, his life mattered too. I can't get nobody for everybody. Life matters. Jesus died for all of us. And I come to tell you now, listen, anybody that's committing racial crimes, God's going to get them. Because everybody you kill, God said, I died for that person. I can't hear nobody here. I died for that white cop. I died for that white cop. I died for that black man. I died for that young teenager that you took out of here. God's going to get him. I can't hear nobody. The wrath of God's going to come down. I come to tell somebody here what's going to end racism. What's not going to end it. Marching in the streets. It's not going to end it. Burning down buildings. It's not going to end it. Shooting up cops. It's not going to end it. The thing that's going to end it for the church is when he raptures us up off this earth. I kept a whole shot. Y'all better hear me. Because as long as we live, it's going to be racism. It ain't left yet. Y'all, come on. It ain't left yet. That's why we got to teach our young black boys. When you going out, if a cop pull you over, say yes, sir. Keep your hand on that steering wheel. God, they ask you to do something, you do what they say. Because this demon of racism is so strong. They wait for you to say the wrong thing to take your life out of here. Are y'all quiet on me here? They waiting for you to look like you want to flinch. They got power to lie on you. Come on. He tried to attack me. And I felt threatened for my life. So I had to shoot him. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. While God's up on shut up. Y'all better hear me now. Teach our young black girls. You can't be out of streets in the night by yourself. They still lynching us now. They still hanging us on trees. Y'all can't hear nobody. They still burning us. Why? Because of racism. It's still alive. They still killing black people. Hanging them. Because that barrier ain't been broken with people. But it's been broken with Jesus. Y'all better hear me now. I thank God I wasn't back in them civil rights days. Because I have to speak out. Come on, somebody. Justice for everybody. Come on. Y'all better hear what I'm saying here. I couldn't sit down and be quiet. Come on. Why the dogs attacking us? I couldn't sit down and be quiet. I can't hear nobody here. Somebody got to say something. You know what we got to say as a church? We got to tell them Jesus saved. Jesus came to deliver. He came to set free. That's what the church got to say. We shouldn't be on the news this time on and telling folks on the news, I'm going to get them when I see them. Now tell them Jesus saves. Oh, can I get a witness of it now? How many know he still saves? And I need his blood for the remission of my sins. Oh God, y'all better hear me now. That white man need the blood for the remission of their sins. Yes, he does, my God. Come on, lift your hands and tell the Lord thank you. Jesus tore down the walls
He tore down racial barriers. Come on, lift your hands and give God the praise. Because after God saved you, He made you love white people. After God saved you, He made you love black people. Can I get a witness in here? When God saved you, you help anybody now. Because you experience the love of God. Can I get a witness up in here? He broke down the barriers in me. I thank God He broke it down. Come on, lift your hands and give God the praise. Because my God is not accepting black or white. But whosoever believes shall be saved. They shall be saved. Come on, lift your hands and thank God for salvation. Come on, thank God for deliverance. Come on, thank Him today. Yes, Lord, thank you. And so, brothers and sisters, I told you before, you should love your race of people. You should love your, I love my race. And I love other people's races. It's good to know your history. It's good to know your heritage. It's good to see. If you want to celebrate Black History Month, it's all right to celebrate it. But don't take it out of context. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. You got to remember you was a wretched undone. You was full of the devil and full of sin. And one day He stopped by and saw you polluted in your own blood. And He stopped by and said, Leah. And I thank God He didn't see my color. And said, you're not the right color. Let me go to the next. I was black as all outdoors. But He still stopped by. And He said, Leah. Can I get some? My God, I wish. Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. He told me to leave. Y'all watch this. He didn't tell me to live fabulously. He didn't tell me to live rich. He told me to live holy. That's why they died for me. To live holy. Can I get somebody here that don't mind giving God some praise this morning? I feel the Holy Ghost in my sanctified hand. I feel it down in my feet. I'm happy to be saved. I'm happy to be delivered. I'm happy to be set free. If you believe it, clap your hands. It didn't take 2013 for me to realize, hallelujah, that my life mattered. Hallelujah. I realized it the moment He saved me. I realized that my life mattered to God. That my breath mattered to God. I realized my God and mercy. I got a God to glorify. I got a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. Can I get a witness in here? Look at somebody here. Tell your neighbor, I'm glad to be saved. I'm glad He brought me out. I'm glad He delivered me. God have mercy. Wait a minute. I got saved in 95. But to be real with you, Sister Linda, my salvation started before 1995. It started 2,000 years ago. But I'm here to witness here. The moment He closed His eyes, my eyes got open. The moment He died on the cross, I became alive. Can I get somebody here that still believe that He broke down the racial barrier? Raise them hands in here. Tell the Lord, thank you. Well, God don't look at my race to justify me. But if you look at the blood of Jesus, it justified me. So I get a witness in here. Well, I wish I could tell my black brother, offend my white brother that's incarcerated. And they'll tell you, Pastor, I stole, I killed, I did everything under the sun. I will tell them, Sister Linda, you've been justified. Oh, you gotta do it's come to Jesus. I can't hear nobody. And when he shoot me, say, he won't bring up my past. I can't hear nobody. I might have killed somebody. I've been justified. I might have stolen. But I've been justified. I might have lied. I've been justified. It don't matter, y'all, what you done today. Somebody here today, they feeling guilty about their sins. I come to tell somebody, I serve a God that justifies, a God that forgives, a God that sanctifies, a God that can wipe the slate clean. If y'all believe it, give my God some praise. Watch this. The middle wall of partition. It was a wall built up inside the sanctuary. And it was so far that the Jews was, the Gentiles was able to walk in. We couldn't participate with the worshipers inside of the veil. Y'all better hear me. We couldn't worship with them inside of the temple. Because we were considered Gentiles. And there was a sign upon the wall that told us, Gentiles, if you perceive this death, there'll be swift death on you. I heard the moment Jesus died, the veil was ripped in two. Can I get a witness now? But when I come into worship, a black church, it's not a white church, it's not a Hispanic church, it's a church that Jesus died to give us, y'all. Can I get somebody to mind praising God for your freedom? Praising God for your deliverance. If you've been bound one day, I want you to praise him for giving you liberty. Can I get a witness here? Some of y'all was on drugs. Some of y'all was walking the street. Some of y'all was whoremongering. Some of y'all was drunkards. But look at Jesus. Pulled you in. Can I get a witness? He pulled me in. Took me out of my racism. Took me out of my prejudice. Took me out of my superiority. He saved me. Can I get somebody that don't mind giving God some praise? Come on, somebody. Lift up your voice. Brother Lord, thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for taking down the barrier. Thank you, Jesus. That's no more white, no more black, no more red. We are all one in Christ. Come on, clap them hands. Oh, I'm almost done. But I feel the Holy Ghost in this house in here. Well, he took down the veil. My God and mercy. But in the Old Testament, the high priest was the only one that could go behind the veil. But now the veil is taken down. I can go behind the veil. I can talk to God. Can I get a witness? By the blood of Jesus, I have access to the Holy of Holies. Somebody here gotta realize you got access. I got access to the presence of God. I got access to be a God. I got access. Y'all better hear me. The power. I got access to salvation. I got access. don't believe y'all believe. I don't believe y'all believe. It's not just for the Jews only. It's for you. It's for you. It's for you. If y'all believe it, clap your hands. Give God the glory. Give God the... Well, I want y'all to hear me now. On the day of Pentecost, it was all in one accord. All the Jews went up to the upper room to wait for the promise of the Holy Ghost. I read in the 2, verse 7 down to 8. And it said they were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, behold, are not all these which speak of the Galileans? All the noise we're hearing coming from the upper room, are they not all Galileans? Wait a minute, I thought they were Jews in the upper room. I hear a sound coming out the upper room. They could understand what they heard. Y'all better hear me. And hallelujah. And they say, how we hear every man in our own tongue. For here he was born. In other words, he broke down the wall. He broke down the language barrier. Y'all better hear me. For when the Holy Ghost comes, it'll make you speak in other languages you never spoken before. I'm a black man speaking to you. You're a white man, but you're speaking Hispanic. Y'all better hear me now. Shopping about the Holy Ghost. Y'all better hear me now. It'll break it down. Something about the Holy Ghost. When you're crying, when you're praising God, something about it. It'll call on you. Y'all better hear me. Something about the Holy Ghost. You can be sleeping through your house, and before you know it, something get a hold of you. You can be right here in church. Just clap your hands. And before you know it, something get down to your bed. It's the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Ghost. You can somebody tell your neighbor. It's the Holy Ghost. When the last time you felt that power. When the last time you felt that anointing. When the last time it knocks you off your feet. I come to tell somebody here. The barrier's broken. The barrier's broken. You can pray. You can shout. You can dance. I can hear no. Well, we got to get it back again. Break the barriers down. Break racism down. Break your hate down. I can't hear nobody. We got to get back to praise with all nations. Can I get a witness? Lord have mercy. Where your praise at? So when you got the Holy Ghost, in the break of praise, it don't matter. Your skin is different. We got the same Holy Ghost. I can't hear nobody. It doesn't matter. God and mercy. We got a different heritage. We got the same blood. So that's what we're living. That same Jesus. When you crucified, he made them both Lord and Christ. Y'all lift your hands. Give God the praise. Well, hold on a second. Some of y'all too heavy for me in here. We said we broke down the barrier, but it still feel like we outside. Like you're outside the veil. But when you're inside the veil, and you come among the anointing, there's something inside the anointing. Something inside the power that'll make you dance. It's something inside the church. Y'all better hear me. When the power's moving, you can't tell me that you're saved. and you don't feel nothing, when the power's moving, you can't tell me you've been delivered and you feel no fire. I heard the Bible say the Holy Ghost comes with fire. He broke the barrier to give me fire. He broke the barrier to give me strength. He broke the barrier to give me tongues. He broke the barrier to stir me up. He broke the barrier to water and flow out of my belly. Somebody here, try to give him praise. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. Like you're sanctified. Give God the praise. He delivered you. Give God the praise. Like he brought you out. Give God the praise. Well, I'm about to let you go home, but I'm praying for the day that God will send the wind again in the apostolic church. Give me some more volume, bro. I want y'all to hear me. I need y'all to hear me pray. Yes, Lord. I'm praying for the day that God will send the wind back to the apostolic church. Y'all better hear me now. For the apostolic church is a church that's got real power. Y'all better hear me now. The apostolic church is a church where demons can't stay around. When I look in the churches now, I see people bound by demons, bound with oppression. I see people, Sister Linda, converted, moved. Well, that's not the apostolic church. Y'all better hear me now. For the apostolic church, we got a wind that blows in the house. Not only the wind blows, but it sets on you. Y'all better hear me. You gotta get back that power again. Get back. Watch out again. Get back. Y'all better hear me. Where's the fire of the Holy Ghost? Where's the anointing? Yeah, Lord. We have so much power. That's so much power. They say preach. Keep on preaching. I got this one. They laid their hands on those bound with devils. And they were delivered. Y'all better hear me. They hands on the sick. And they recovered. They hands on the blinded eye. And the eyes began to open. You gotta come back. You gotta come back. Cause the battle I've been removed. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Somebody here gotta praise him like you know his name. Praise him like you're sanctified. Praise him like you're born again. Praise him like you're filled with the Holy Ghost. Praise him like you got joy. I'm speaking for joy. Somebody, somebody gotta pray. The barrier has been broken. I said the barrier has been broken. That means I got room to move. I got room to praise him. No more chains. It's holding me down in my place. Y'all don't believe me. We got all this room. We got all this freedom. Yes, Lord. We got all this freedom. and you don't gotta pay. I don't understand how they say this pay, and you ain't gotta pay. Well, I read about the lame man. Sleep up the dirty beautiful, begging alms of everybody that came into the trip. For he saw Peter and John, and Peter said, look on this. He's looking at Peter, thinking Peter gonna give him some money. But Peter said, shiver and go. Have I none of such as I have? Rise up and walk. The Bible said, his ankles will see his strength. He got up and began to walk. But this is my point. The Bible said, you thought it leaving. You thought it praising. But God delivered him. I want to know today what he brought you out of. If he brought you out, it should be a leap. It should be a dance. It should be a shout. Because the barrier has been broken. Look at somebody. Ask your neighbor. Has the barrier been broken? For not praising me. Ask him, why not praising? If the barrier's broken, why not praising? If you're living, why not praising? If you're free, why not praising? If you got joy, why not praising? If you're shaken, why not praising? If you're healed, why not praising? If you got peace, why not praising? If you brought you out, why not praise it? If you're out of town, why not praise it? If you're not trying, I don't think y'all ready. I think I better go home. Some of y'all looking at me. Some of y'all looking at me. Like you still dry in the back. Like you still got dry bones in the back. But I heard the dry bones in the valley didn't stay dry for very long. There was a wind that blew. The barrier was the grave. It was dry in the grave. And when the wind blew, bone came back to bone. Skin came back on the body. They stood up and walked. I gotta address somebody. If you came out the bed and you got the spirit on you, I dare you move your body. I dare you to God some prayer. I dare you to lift the mud. I dare you. Oh, shut that. We need that wind to blow. We need that wind to blow. I don't know about y'all in here. I want that same Holy Ghost that they had in the book of Acts. That same Holy Ghost. You couldn't bind them up, Sister Linda. They had too much power. You lock them in jail. They're singing praise. And God will get them out. You couldn't bind them power. I can't hear nobody. I don't know what you're bound with. If you start praising them, you'll release the barrier. I can't hear nobody. If you gotta run, I dare you to run. If you gotta leap, I dare you to leap. I want that same Holy Ghost, that same power, that same anointing. When I lay hands on your head, the Holy Ghost is gonna come. When I walk past you, my shadow will heal you. My handkerchief will deliver. That same power that cast out devils. That same power that wrought miracles. Signs and wonders. I want that power. I need that power. We need it all. If y'all believe it, give God the praise. If y'all believe it, give God the glory. See, the Holy Ghost, it removes the barriers. I came to church, I couldn't praise him. But the Holy Ghost will remove a barrier. It'll move that thing that's hidden in your place. I can't get nobody here. Yes, Lord Jesus. Remove the barrier, God. You got to bleed like blind Bartimaeus. Lord, I hear you. But I can't see. I hear the word. I see the manifestation. I hear you, Jesus. But I'm not seeing nothing happen. You got to cry out and say, Lord, mercy on me. He can't come out. He didn't allow the barriers to hinder his blessing. He didn't allow the barriers to hinder the miracle. He didn't allow his condition to make him miss his miracle. I hear God saying, yeah, somebody here trying to praise him for some miracle is up the line. Somebody gotta worship him. Your healing is up the line. Move the barrier out the way. Your healing, your deliverance, your miracle, your children's deliverance is on the line. Somebody gotta do it. Your niece, your nephew is on the line. Come on, somebody. Your wife, your husband, your uncle, your lady, your granddaddy, your grandma, deliverance is on the line. Hey! I think we're getting there. We're getting there. Well, your confined space could be your barrier. Your seat could be your barrier. Standing in one place could be your barrier. But somebody got to move out the barrier and tell the Lord, I need you, Lord. And tell your neighbor, believe me, I'm coming out my barrier. Lord have mercy. Say, I'm moving back for me. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Your barrier may be your seat. I can't move from this seat. But God might be telling you, your miracle's at the altar. God could be telling you, your miracle's at the door. God could be telling you, your miracle's at the wall. Run to the wall. That's what he might be telling some of us. Run to the wall and talk to God. Your miracle may be running up and down the sidewalk. Remove the barrier. Look at somebody. Tell your neighbor, I feel my help now. Tell your neighbor, remove the barrier. You already did it. Now you gotta do it. Remove the barrier. Your blessing may be in your leap. Your blessing may be in your prayer. Your blessing may be in your shout. Your blessing may be in your hand wave. Your blessing may be in your run. Your blessing may be in your shout. May be in your dance. Somebody gotta come on back. Come on back to Pentecost. Come on back. Back to the anointing. Come on back to speaking in tongues. Come on back to a holy dance. Come on back to give the God praise. Come on back. Come on back.
all right. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
But I feel something. Peter says, seven, go. I don't have no seven, go. But he said, what I have, I got some anointing to pull you up. Come on, pull him up. He grabbed him by the right hand. He pulled him up. Yeah! Ah, yeah! Yeah! He pulled him up. The barriers was gone. Man of God, the barriers was gone. He grabbed him by the right hand. Pulled him up. And the barrier was gone. The barriers was gone. He pulled him up. It don't matter your color. It don't matter your race. You can praise him like I can. You got that same Jesus whom they crucified. God has made him both Lord and Christ. Men and brethren, what shall we do? I heard. Let me please and be baptized. Every one of you, my God, the remission of your sin, and you shall receive the gift of the barriers, the barriers. The barriers, he pulled him up. He pulled him up. Pulled him up. Said, receive your strength. He pulled him up. Receive your strength. I don't believe I came to have church this morning. I don't believe y'all believe that the barriers is gone. I don't think y'all believe it. If y'all believe it, I see on the outside. What's on the inside? I see on the outside. What's the praise on the inside? I can't get nobody. Out of here. I praise him. I got a few more minutes. And I'm going to my seat. I come to tell somebody. It's not a Sunday morning. That's only familiar. It's not a regular Sunday. I come to tell you. You can praise him. If you're black, you can praise him. If you're white, you can praise him. If you're Hispanic, you can praise him. If you're Indian, you can praise him. If you're Chinese, you can praise him. If you're Asian, you can praise him. If you're Latin, you can praise him. If you're German, you can praise him. If you're Russian, you can praise him. And everything, and have work. I'm taking my break between the rounds. I'm sitting in my seat. I'm looking around to see what.